Well, I suppose it started, as I said, at Cambridge, but after my house jobs, I went into the army, which was national service, for many years after the end of the war. It was 2 years national service and 3 years on the reserve when you did 2 weeks a year of extremely idle military service. And I had an old friend, he's dead now, Bob Torrance, who was a physiologist, a Don of the Dons, wonderful man. He was Oxford actually, but we met as students at UCH. And he went to work at Porton, where the secret stuff was done, and also a lot of public stuff. And he said there was this interesting place called the Microbiological Research Establishment, where there was really interesting work on microbiology and infection, which was in the public wheel and was all published and everything. And he said, why don't you apply to go there? So I applied for Porton first and the Far East second, because I thought if I didn't get there, the last thing I wanted to do was be stuck in a boring army camp in Germany, which was what the other thing you did mainly. Yeah. So it was Porton. And then I did 2 years full-time research, which led to my MD and all that sort of stuff and papers. And it was on how mucins promote infection. What happens is that in an experimental model, if you inject, say, typhoid, and it might take, say, 10 to the 6th or 10 to the 7th organisms to kill the mice. If you put it in with a bit of mucin, the lethal dose is grossly diminished by, say, 10 to the 3, 4, 5, 6 even, so 100, 1,000, maybe 10 to the 3, 4. And why did that happen? What was the process that was allowing the organism to get going? And anyway, that was what I worked on.
Was that your concern? Was it something that you found yourself interested in, or was it a program already going?
No, it was a new thing. The boss of the place offered me three projects. Mm-hmm. I can't remember the third one. One was a very, very biochemical thing in pharmacology. I knew I definitely wouldn't be up to that. The second one, I can't remember what it was, but the third, that sounded interesting to me. Mm-hmm. And it was very interesting, it was.